Okay, so we're going to work on this dimensional analysis practice worksheet. The first one has pounds and ounces, pounds and ounces. You know, you can write your weights in several ways, so I want to talk about all the different ways you can write them. Use a little dimensional analysis at the same time so that you can figure out which way you want to write your weight. So, for example, someone may have said that a baby was born and the baby weighed 4 pounds, 2 ounces. Well, you can record that weight as just pounds. However, just pounds, it's not fair to say the baby weighed 4 pounds. That doesn't make any sense because the baby didn't weigh exactly 4 pounds. The baby weighed 4 point something pounds. Okay, had a little bit more than 4 pounds. So I can't do that, but it's going to end up being a decimal, 4 point something in pounds. And so we're going to try to figure out what the decimal part is. Now the decimal part comes from something that's not a full pound, which would be the 2 ounces. So what I'd like to do is to convert the ounces into pounds, just that little part. Dimensional analysis says I can do 2 ounces over 1, multiply it by a unit fraction. Now what has to go in the denominator here?
Ounces,
right. Is there a conversion straight from ounces to pounds?
Yes.
Okay. 16 ounces is the same thing as 1 pound. And as I mentioned, you can type this on your calculator. We don't have to do but just one step. And we have our unit of pounds. We can type this in the calculator as 2. And then what would you put in front of the 16? Oh, it's on the bottom. Since it's on the bottom, you hit divide. So you'll type in your calculator 2 and divide 16. Now, fortunately, that decimal does terminate, and you end up with this decimal. If you read it properly, that's 125 thousandths. Okay? But I'm not going to worry about that part right now. What unit goes with this? Pounds. So what I have figured out is the baby was told to be weighed 4 pounds, 2 ounces. Now I know the baby weighs 4.125 pounds, or 4 and 125 thousandths of a pound. So if you're asked to put it in just pounds, this is the kind of thing I'm asking you for. The whole pounds and then a little piece of it. Now the other way I want you to write your answer is just ounces. Now you can't say the baby weighs just 2 ounces because the baby weighs more than 2 ounces. But what you can do is work on the pounds and figure out how many ounces are in those pounds. And again, I can do a little bit of dimensional analysis and take my 4 pounds over 1. What should go on the bottom?
Pounds.
What should go on top? And we know from the previous problem, 16 ounces, same thing as 1 pound. And I said, be careful, don't turn this into an 11. Keep some space. How do you type that one in your calculator? Okay, 16's on top, so 4 times 16. You're looking at 64 what? Ounces. And I'll go back and mark out what went away and what unit I still have. Now, is that my answer in ounces?
No.
Because I already had 2 ounces and I have 64 ounces.
So you have to add it.
You have to add those two together and you end up with 66 ounces. You want to give the final weight in ounces, so to get to know to add, you have to take the ounces you had from the 4 pounds and the ounces you had from your plain old ounces. So I'm combining them for a total weight, so that would make me add.
So the first one was converting ounces into pounds, and this one is converting pounds into ounces.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And that just depends on how you want to write the weight. You know, if a baby is born, most people are going to say this kind of thing. But on occasion, you will hear someone say this kind of thing. Rarely will you see this one, but they could use it if they wanted to. But it depends on how you want to report it. So there are two others. I'm going to let you try those on your own. And I'm going to go to number two, which is feet and inches. And this is another situation where sometimes you report your height a certain way. And once you report it that way, you could report it a different way. Okay? So for number two, I'm going to do the first one. And you have 4 feet, 4 inches. Now you can report your height as 4 feet, 4 inches. That's pretty much what we do on a regular basis. I would say I'm 5'3", or you might say I'm 6'2". You know, we tend to report our height that way, but could we report it as just feet, or could we report it as just inches? Now, just feet would be 4 point something feet. So which part do I need to convert? The inches part. So I'm going to look at the 4 inches, and I'm going to convert that into feet. So what has to go on the bottom?
Inches.
Inches has to go there, no question about it. This is a conversion I already know. So I'm looking at 12 inches and 1 foot. And you may have already known in your head how to do this one, but now you've proven why you want to do it this way. Will you say 4 divided by 12 or 4 times 12? 4 divided by 12, because 12 is on the bottom. So in your calculator, do 4 divided by 12. Now this one doesn't terminate. So let's just take the liberty, since I didn't give you any instructions. Let's go to the hundredths place. 0.33. And what would my unit be?
Feet.
And if you're not sure about that, go back and cross out the inches. You're left with feet. So it has to be feet. So now combine this foot answer with the foot answer I already had. So I add them together. And my final answer, another way that I could tell you my height, is 4.33 feet. Or 4 33/100 of a foot. That's possible.
So you said take the 4 foot and add it to
mm-hmm. And basically what we're doing is this is in feet, this isn't. So we put this in feet. Mm-hmm. Combine them together, so that's adding. Mm-hmm. So that's why I'll say 4.33 feet.
Okay.
Or 4 33/100 of a foot. Okay. Now what if I want to make it just inches? And this is the other most common way to give height, especially when you might have something and it's based on inches. You don't want to give feet and inches as your height. You want to give it just inches. Well, I've got 4 inches already, but this part's not in inches. But I could make it be in inches. So I can take my 4 feet over 1, what has to go on the bottom,
feet,
and 1 foot is 12 inches. Now, these digits are the same, but one is feet and one is inches, so I could have had different numbers there.
One you're going to divide and one you're going to time.
Mm-hmm. And that's because one was a foot and one was an inch. So 4 times 12. So it looks like I'm at 48. So the feet cancel out. The inches are left. So that means this has to be 48 inches. So what's the overall height?
You have to add the 4 inches.
So the 48 inches and the 4 inches for a total of 52 inches. So it just depends on how you want to write it and what you've started with. And I'll let you try the other two on your own, where you start with feet and inches. The biggest thing is, don't assume that this smaller piece tells you the decimal. They're completely different numbers. A 4 and then 3, 3, they're not the same digits. So you can't just go from one to the other and just look at it and know the answer. You have to go through some kind of process. And dimensional analysis will help you get it where you have no questions about your answer. You know you're right. And it's foolproof. Okay? All right, so try the other two on your own. And